Are you a toolmaker in the process of creating new tools with extreme demands and hardness and wear resistance? I hope you're aware that development of new tools is expensive and time-consuming, from drawing to prototyping to initial implementation, not to mention getting all the way to large-scale production. Today, we're going to talk about a new way to make products that meet the highest demands, with the flexibility of 3D printed materials. Let's jump right in and have a look at an example.
So, VBN components, you produce extremely wear-resistant metals by 3D printing.
Yes, we do. We just need a 3D CAD drawing and a number as to how many parts you need. And then, of course, we have to have a discussion about where to add grinding allowance.
Whoa. 3D printing. Isn't that extremely slowly? I heard that printing solid metal takes ages, and you need thousands of units. You need a pressing die, you need the sintering parameters, you need minimum wall thicknesses. We will never make this on time.
Well, you come from a traditional industry, don't you?
Well, these are other questions that arise in my head.
But let's take this from the beginning.
Okay.
Assume that you need this cutting tool. Basically, what you do is that you send us a VBN, a 3D CAD drawing, and then we'll discuss which vibrante alloy you need, and then we'll just print it with our standard settings.
Okay.
Generally, what we do is that we're printing or smelting metal powder according to your drawing.
Okay, but if I look into this detail here, there is something here that wasn't on the drawing. This looks like my grandmother's curtains.
Well, that is actually the support structure or wafer.
Okay.
In printing, you need to have some form of material to be able to remove the heat from each building later. If you don't have it, the part will become deformed.
Okay, then I understand. But is it easy to decrease the wafer structure? Because this looks quite much for grinding away.
Of course. I mean, if we can work with your build and run some tests, we can always minimize the wafer. As you can see for this part.
Ah, much better. Much less. This is very, very interesting. But how can I... this is just a copy of an existing product. How can I get from this stage into redesigning the component? Is that difficult?
Well, that is actually relatively easy. We can always combine product improvement and process optimization, which we've actually done for this part. As you can see here, we've almost removed the wafer altogether.
Okay.
And we've also added several cooling channels for increased performance. This is what we call design for AM. We've reduced the support structure so much that it's very easy to remove in the blasting cabinets.
Very interesting. Much less wafer, I can see. So you mean that the development time for getting from a copy of an existing product into a design for AM product with improved performance, that time is very, very short.
Exactly. You can print 1, 10, or 100 parts directly. And these are actually built to full quality, so you can test these in real production. To sum up, you should not only look at the actual print time, you have to compare it with the traditional manufacturing processes.
Okay, so you mean that the production time traditional is much more than just the machining time, the drilling, milling and turning?
Exactly.
Interesting. Very, very interesting. But this is an amazing concept. How can a customer move into this?
Well, you can start with a pre-study here at VBN. Test and improve. And then if you want to order a smaller series, you can do so directly from us. And if you want larger series, we can actually help you with a license. And then you can print these products at your own production. Of course, VBN will provide you with all the necessary knowledge and settings and etc. on how to print these and produce these parts at your own premise.
Fantastic.
We call this concept AMHSS. We build your prototype in the intended material. Testing and product development. serial production at VBN or license production at your facility?
This is very, very interesting. I have one final question.
Shoot.
Is it possible to print this wafer separately? I think they look very nice.
That's all we had for this video of our fast product making process. Do you want to know how we can improve your production? Drop us a line. Thanks for watching.